everyone, first of all, happy new year to all of you. I hope you're all doing well, staying healthy. Hopefully you got to at least see your families over the holidays and spend some time just letting out that giant collective exhale I know all of us have been waiting for with the new year. I'm certainly not one to wish time away. I think that's useless, but it does feel good to move into 2021 and start looking ahead at all the great things that this year is going to bring. Today, Brian and I want to sit down and we're actually going to talk about what happened in 2020 at the shop, give you a kind of a year-end review, our highlights of the year, being on the water and being in the shop, and talk about what's going to be happening in 2021. So sit down, hang out for a second, and let's get right to it. Let's start off with your New Year. What'd you do for New Year's?
You know, Matt, I didn't do a whole lot for New Year's because it's the year of COVID. But fortunately, my mom came up and Lily was able to come out to the house, and we just kind of hung out, laid low. There's a family tradition that we have of doing a pork loin with sauerkraut. Ooh. Some German good luck thing. So
sounds good.
I made a really awesome little pork loin with some sauerkraut. So it was fantastic.
I think New Year's is great because it's usually centered around some good food, and you can really appreciate it. It's finally gotten really cold here in Michigan. Annie and I did a seafood extravaganza. We did crab legs and lobster, and we did the full food coma thing, which
nice.
Was really nice. And then we spent a day in recovery afterwards. Brian, what was the toughest thing for you about 2020? It could be anything. It can shop
Boy,
stuff. It
you
could
know,
be.
For me, the toughest thing with 2020, I think, was you know, when they finally just shut us down, and we had just taken on all of our spring orders. They kicked us off the river, so you know, right away we lost all of our guide trips. You know, I panicked. It was very scary. Very unsettling whether or not we're going to have an income, whether or not we're going to have a shop, whether yeah. or not we're going to keep this business afloat. So I think, you know, that was a full-on, you know, solid 7 days of just straight
we
up
were
panic.
We just didn't know. It was we a lot of uncertainty
know.
I mean, we were constantly on our phones trying to see if there were updates. Of course, we're concerned about,
you know, we want to
families
make sure
getting
healthy.
Sick and things
right.
like that, but you know, like to be able to pay
yeah,
bills
was,
too.
I,
so
I did not yeah. want to go through that again. And you know, obviously, you know, we were able to get everything up online and able to get through the year. And we actually had a great year.
We so, did. We feel yeah. really, really lucky
yeah.
that we had a good year. We try not to celebrate because we know a lot of people didn't. But
well,
we feel very lucky.
Who knows what the next 6 months or a year
right.
is going
exactly.
to bring. You know?
So we're going like, to try and keep it going.
Keep humble.
Yeah.
Keep pushing our nose to the ground and doing what we do best, and
right.
that's providing with great service, great products, and look to improve every year.
Yeah.
Matt, what was your like
toughest part about
2020?
Well, my wife Annie and I had just gotten back from New Mexico. I think we got shut down just a few days after we got back.
I think
which
it was.
I mean, we were reading the stories as we were getting on the plane, thinking, "Wow, is this gonna? We're gonna make it there? What's the deal?" So we end up not doing. Kind of just vetoed all of our other major trips we had planned. We were going to do some canoeing up in Canada. We had some fishing trips that got canceled. That was really tough. Luckily, we're really tight-knit. My parents are really close by, and my in-laws are as well. So we were close enough we could see family and keep everybody within a bubble, which was really nice. But that was really tough, and I'm really looking forward to, you know, staying healthy in 2021 and doing some safe travel. I was just texting with John. We're going to do Muskie Camp, I think, this
nice.
Fall.
Fantastic.
My wife and I are going to do an anniversary trip. So it'll be, I think, a gradual working back to where we were is hopefully what I'm looking forward to.
So
this
where
coming
were
year.
Where you were. Now, what was the craziest thing that you like kind of took part of during
oh,
quarantine?
Oh, crazy quarantine trends. And I would love to hear from all of you what your
crazy ones
trends were. What did you do? What did you not do? We didn't.
Did you make bread?
I did not. I didn't buy a single thing of flour. No, I did because we make
Did
pancakes.
You hoard toilet paper?
Maybe.
Yeah, a little bit. I think everybody was, right? You know, like you get on the
little
trend.
A little bit. I mean, we did the Tiger King thing during quarantine, and that was
Joe Exotic.
That provides some laughs.
I think everybody did that. That was dark, and
it was it turned out.
You know, I don't think that show would have been a hit if it weren't for quarantine.
Oh, come on.
Because you look at your life, you know, everybody feels badly. And like, wow, look at this. It's even worse to be this guy. And gosh, what a crazy screw.
We had
up
an idea this spring, too. We were going to do a spoof with Brian as
Tiger.
Brian Exotic.
Yeah.
And we were going to put a tiger costume on Storm and
right.
be in the boat. Anyways, thank goodness that idea Thank goodness
we didn't act upon that idea. For this year, what's one piece of equipment that you really hope to get that you saw last year, maybe that we couldn't get for you to play with to add to your personal arsenal?
I see a gap in my personal arsenal probably with my light streamer rods. I'd really like to get something that's a lot nicer. I fish a ton of 6-weights. We fish the Boardman a lot. We fish high up on the Upper Manistee a lot. Places where you don't always need an 8-weight. You don't need a 250, 300 grain tip. So I've looked at...
You don't need to throw a baby muskrat.
No,
fly.
No. You can. Good for you. But I've looked at the Sage Sonic. We could not get one of those.
I tell you that 5-weight's sweet. I'm going to get one of those.
Are you?
5-weight.
For dry flies?
I took one out west this year and I absolutely loved it.
Yeah.
Great dry
fly. I remember when Ben brought those. Everyone's eyes lit up like, we need this. That I've looked at, you know, IMX is a great series as well. The new streamer rods from Echo.
I'm excited to go fish the new streamer.
Pretty cool.
Streamer
we're
going to
go fish the new streamer. Is it the
Streamer X?
It's the Extreme, just like Kelly.
Super excited to go fish those and try that out, actually.
Yeah. Maybe we'll do a little review sometime on the water.
I was super impressed by the musky rod.
Yeah, that was cool.
So, I'm definitely adding one of those to my arsenal.
Maybe I need a musky rod.
Especially if you're doing musky camp.
Yeah. What are you guys buying in 2021? What's on your wish list that you might not have been able to get last year? Or is just something you've been thinking about? Let's talk about what we have coming up. It is, you know, very beginning of January. And
tying season is right upon us.
Tying season is, yes, cresting above us. It's happening. I'm looking at the shelves. I'm glad we placed some big orders, and more materials are always on the way. We're always cycling through stuff.
We do order stuff every week. So if there's something you're looking for that we don't have, sometimes twice a week we're doing materials orders. And we're happy to always special order you something.
Yep, absolutely.
Even let us know what you're looking for that we don't have.
Even if you're not an in-the-shop customer, you're an online customer, that's what our email's for. That's what our phone number's for. Just call us. Brian and I are pretty much going to be here all winter.
Absolutely.
You're going somewhere.
I'm hoping to go to Mexico.
Mr. Ben Hunting
is turning 50.
Having a birthday.
So we're going to try and go back, and I have a score to settle with some permits. So let's... I'm keeping my fingers crossed that...
Brian, is it true you have a space in your arm waiting?
I do have space, maybe,
waiting
for that.
The permit?
Yeah,
okay.
And I do have a, sight lines cuff that... I did get the permit cuff, but I'm not going to,
You're waiting.
Wear it.
You're waiting. Sorry,
I don't want to jinx myself.
If you haven't checked them out yet, we're doing live fly tying every Wednesday night. We've done 5 or 6 so far.
Yeah,
which
Johnny
is,
Ray is coming
Johnny
up
Johnny Ray
week.
Is going to be coming up this Wednesday, and then we have Corey Golden. Then we had, and then we're rolling into some big heavy hitters. Ed McCoy is going to do a game changer night for us. Really excited about that. Russ Madden's going to do one. We're even going to bring in some of Brian's friends from the West Coast.
So we're going to try and line something up with some remote
friends,
fly time.
Some big names you'll definitely recognize.
We'll have fun with it.
We'll announce that as we go forward. But looking forward in 2021, we're just excited to be bringing you more quality content, whether it's fly tying, whether it's tips and tricks, things like that. So this is your opportunity. Down below in the comments, let us know what you want to see in 2021 from us. We'll do our best to kick it out for you. I know Brian and I are going to dive deep into some steelhead rigging stuff this winter, everyone ready for the spring, making sure you are rigged up and feeling confident on the water.
We're going to do a lot of different product videos, so look for a lot more video content from us coming up in 2021, just so you can help educate yourself on what's the best product for me, whether it's a reel, a rod, a fly line, whatever it may be. Those are all big purchases, and we want to help you educate you on the best buying decision that you can make. Even
it's
if
overwhelming,
you can't
make it
there's
into a the
lot
shop. Of stuff out there.
Absolutely.
All right, thanks everyone. We hope you have a killer 2021.
Let's hope to turn the page and get through this, and maybe by the end of 2021 we will have somewhat back to normal.
Yeah.
So
stay healthy, stay everyone. Stay healthy.
Thank
Please.
You so much. We appreciate your support, and have a happy new year.
Yeah. Happy new year.